sit down, please. So now today we are going to start with the poem on killing a tree. It is after reach for the top. Okay, on killing a tree. Please open up your books with this poem that is on killing a tree. So now what this poem on killing a tree is refers to. So you know on killing a tree means? Deforestation, cutting of trees. Okay. But actually this poem is not exactly only about deforestation. Okay. Third, it is not exactly about deforestation because the poet has compared trees with that of, you can say, with that of human beings. Like if you can cut a tree. Okay, so what will happen? Suppose you cut a branch of tree. What will happen? After some time, yes? Yes, supply of oxygen, of course, it is affected. But after it, what happens? When you cut a tree, it will regrow. Its branches will curl out with new sproutings, okay, from the sides where the cut is made. And ultimately, the tree will again grow and into a complete tree. And the poet is saying for killing a tree, what is required? Okay, the poet is saying that for cutting a tree, it is to be uprooted. The sap, okay, what is sap? You know, in case of trees, what is sap? Liquid, okay, latex, what we called you in scientific language, that oozes out when a cut is made in some of the trees. And in other trees where bark is, there are some trees, they are giving out gums and all that, right? Okay. So actually the sap, which is equated to that of blood in human beings. Okay. Like blood is equated to that of this sap in case of trees. When this is to be exposed. Okay. And trees, they are completely uprooted. Okay. Only then what is happening, it causes killing of a tree. It means simple jab. Jab means cut. Simple jab or hack or cutting of a tree, it will never kill a tree. What it will require? It will require uprooting of the tree. Much strength is required in order to kill a tree. Okay. So the poet, Jeb Patel, he has brought about or he has equated trees to that of human beings. Okay. So very sensitive poem it is. The poet is equating this tree with that of, you can say, human beings. Like human beings, they are, for example, they are to be killed. Okay, they are killed. Similarly, trees, they are also killed when they are uprooted, when their sap is exposed, when that the living liquid, okay, which is responsible for providing life to the tree, when they are exposed only, when they are given only then what happens, that there happens to be the death of the tree. Otherwise, if you cut a tree, what will happen? It will regrow again. Okay, new leaves will be sprouted out. Okay. And the poet has also compared this, when the cut is made, the liquid oozes out. He has also compared it with that of bleeding bark. Okay, bleeding bark. Okay, metaphorically it is used here. Okay, it is a metaphor used here and in which the poet is saying that when, like, the bark is bleeding means if it is giving out some liquid. Okay, but ultimately what happened after some time, this cut which has been made on the bark of the tree, it will be repaired. Okay, it will, you can say, and the new leaves and the branches, they will regrow out from that place. Okay. So this is the main thing that the poet, he wants to express through this poem. Okay. So now there are different kind of literary devices used here. First of all, on killing a tree. Okay. On killing a tree, mainly tree is personified here. Okay. Because why? Because it is compared to that of human being. Okay. Right. Throughout the poem, personification is used. Note down, please, on the books. That throughout the poem, personification is used and in which the poet is portraying the tree as a human being. What he is doing, he is portraying the tree as a human being. So throughout the poem, the poet is portraying the tree as a human being. So what is this? So this is an example of what? This is an example of personification. Okay, so this is an example of personification used here. Okay, now see, it takes much time to kill a tree. It takes much time to kill a tree means the tree is not easily killed. If you will cut, you many times you have seen that completely the bark is chopped off the tree. But what will happen after few days, even a month or so, what happens? That new leaves, they sprout out of the bark also. And with no sooner time, what happens? This tree, it is converted back into a complete tree. First of all, a plant. Okay. Then ultimately, it is converted into a complete tree. Okay. It takes much time to kill a tree. Now, the poet is saying that it takes, it is of course required much time to kill a tree. Means tree is not easily killed, but it, what it requires a lot of time to kill a tree. Not a simple jab of the knife. Not a simple jab of the knife. Jab of the knife means it is an example of, sorry, jab means cut. Okay. Not a simple jab of the knife. It means that not a simple cut of the knife. With not only a cut, simple cut of the knife, you will be able to kill a tree. No. If cut is made, that doesn't mean the death of the tree. Okay. Will do it. Now see here, not a simple jab of the knife will do it. Jab of the knife will do it. It is carried forward onto the next line. Yes, very good. So this is an example of enjambment. So this is an example of enjambment. What is enjambment? Okay. When the idea of one line is carried forward to the next line without use of punctuation marks, then like comma or full stop, any, right? Then what is this? This is called as enjambment. Okay, so now you got, Sarthak, you got what is enjambment? Tell me what is enjambment. Stand up. What is enjambment? When idea of line, it is carried forward. Okay, but see here, at the end of this line, not a simple jab of the knife. Okay, after this, there is no comma, no full stop. And idea is carried on to the next line. Will do it. Okay, so this is what? This is an example of enjambment. Okay, what is this? This is an example of enjambment. Okay, and it has grown slowly, consuming the earth. Again, this is what? Enjambment. Sit down, please. So this is again an example of enjambment. Okay, why this is an example of enjambment? Idea is carried forward onto the next line. Yes, Heaven, what is enjambment? Idea? From one person? Then it is called as communication. Huh? I'm asking enjambment. Actually, you are not paying attention. This is just a waking call for you. Okay. Now listen to me. What is enjambment? See the line. Not a simple jab of the knife will do it. Okay. So now here, not even a simple cut on the tree or on the outer side of the tree will kill the tree. Okay. So now here it is that not a simple jab of the knife will do it. Jab of the knife and will do it is in the next line. It is carried forward. Idea is carried forward onto the next line. Okay, but there is no punctuation mark after jab of the knife, like full stop or comma. So this is an example of enjambment. And in the next line also, it has grown slowly, consuming the earth. Again, here the same thing is repeated here, that the idea is carried forward onto the next line. Okay, without, you can say without any punctuation mark. So this is also again an example of enjambment. Right. Please sit down. So, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, absorbing, see, slowly consuming the earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, absorbing years of sunlight, air, and water. Rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, and absorbing years of sunlight, air, and water. What is this? Very good. So, this is again an example of enjambment. This is again an example of enjambment given here. So now when you read these lines, what it means? Slowly consuming the earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, absorbing years of sunlight, air, and water. Right. So it means that when a cut is made on the tree, so what will happen? That it will regrow. How it will regrow? By consuming natural resources. It means it comes out of the earth, means rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, means feeding up, means from the surface of the earth. It is consuming the nutrients, it is taking out the nutrients, feeding upon its crust, absorbing years of sunlight. Absorbing means the sunlight, okay, which is being delivered, okay, by the sun. It is absorbing that sunlight also, air and water. Now, when you are reading these lines, an image is created in our minds. Image is created, rising out of it, absorbing up and feeding upon its crust. So, what is this? This is an example of imagery. Note down, please, in your books that this is an example of imagery. So, what is imagery? Imagery means like when you read, okay? Okay, so here an image is created. So, this is visual imagery. There are different types of imageries. Okay, this is visual imagery. An imagery is created. Okay, a picture is created in front of our eyes. So, this is the reason why this is an example of imagery. Okay, an image is created. It means when you read lines, sometimes it appeals to your senses. Sometimes an image is created, visual imagery. Sometimes when a sound is described, you feel hearing that sound. And you can just reproduce in your mind, yes, this kind of sound is produced. So what is this? This is an example of? This is not an example of visual when hearing is made, okay? I will discuss about it later on. So now, years of sunlight, air, water, and out of its leprous hide, yes. Leprous hide, sprouting leaves. Understand the meaning of this leprous hide clearly. First of all, what is this leprous hide? Of course, leprous hide. First of all, leprous hide is a metaphor. What is metaphor? I am again repeating that metaphor is a literary poetic device in which comparison is made, but without use of like or as. There is no use of like or as. When this kind of comparison is made, this is called as metaphor. Now here in this case, leprous hide, a comparison is made. Okay. So what this leprous hide? You know the bark of the tree. What kind of bark? What kind of bark it is? It is stout, dark, uneven. It's not an even uneven. When you touch it, when you feel it, you feel the uneven touch and you feel that it is not so smooth. And it is compared to the skin of a human being who is suffering from leprosy. Leprosy. You know what is leprosy? It's a disease. Okay, skin disease, highly infectious, contagious in nature. Okay, it means that it can be transmitted easily from one person to another. Okay, earlier this kind of disease, it was considered of, you can say, of very, you can say, fatal nature. Okay, but these days we can't see these kind of diseases much because much treatment has been provided. And the skin of the person, what it dwells? Well, warts, moles. From which liquid oozes out. Okay, right? And it is very, you can say, it's very contagious, of course, and it is not so pleasing to see such kind of person. Okay, right? And now he has compared, because the bark of the tree which is matured one, from this what happens? Liquid oozes out, okay, in the form of gum or latex. So this is the reason why this is compared to the skin of the person who is suffering from leprosy. Okay, so what it is compared to? It is compared to the skin of the person who is suffering from leprosy, or you can say it is discolored one. Right? And out of its leprous hide sprouting leaves. So it means that poet is saying that by absorbing years of sunlight, nutrients, it is able to heal itself, and it is able to give out, it is able to reproduce its leaves again, and branches started sprouting out, which can ultimately grow into a complete tree. So from this very first stanza, the poet wants to deliver that it is not so easy to kill a tree. Okay, it means that with this simple jab or cut, okay, at the bark of the tree, it will not bring an end to the life of a tree. Because why it is not able to bring an end to the life of a tree? Because with the passage of time, it will start again absorbing, it will consume the earth, it will start absorbing nutrients, sunlight from the earth. And ultimately, what will happen? It will regrow into a complete tree. What will happen? That it will ultimately regrow into a complete tree. Okay, so this is the reason why the poet is saying that it is not the simple jab or cut on the bark of a tree will cut a tree. So let us revise once again. Okay, what are the poetic devices used here? First of all, mainly which poetic devices used? Personification. The tree, it means that, yes, the poet is portraying tree as a human being. So see here, not a simple jab of the knife will do. It means the tree will not be killed. It means it is treated as a human being here, and consuming the earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust. Feeding upon its crust, what? It means it is feeding like human beings, and feeding is a human quality which is attributed to that of this tree, absorbing years of sunlight and out of its leprous hide. Again, there is metaphorical comparison with that of the skin of a person who is suffering from leprosy. So here in the complete stanza also there is personification used. Okay, and moreover, slowly consuming the earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, absorbing years of sunlight. What is this? This is an example of imagery also, right? Enjambment, of course, it is used, but again, it is an example of imagery used here. Right now, clear? Okay, so now, see the next. So, hack and chop. Okay, hack and chop means, again, cut. Okay, hack and chop means, that means the cut that has been given, okay, right, okay, or you can say hack is a rough cut, okay, if we means not deliberate one, anywhere, any cut on the bark of the tree or any part of the tree, but this alone won't do it means this alone, this means that this cut which has been given on the bark of the tree, it will not cut the tree, it will not kill the tree, it will not make the tree to die. Okay, so this is again an example of enjambment. So this is, write down please, this is again an example of enjambment. Book me up, please bring book. Right? So, not so much pain will do it. It means that if you will try to give much pain to the tree also, okay, by producing this type of hack or chaff, this will also not cause the death of the tree. Okay, it means not so much pain. It means that the tree is again considered as a human being. It means which feels pain when cut is made, okay, on the bark of the tree or any part of the tree. So as I told you that throughout the poem, the poet is using the poetic device that is personification. It means that tree is personified throughout the poem. Okay, so not so much pain will do it. And if you will try to cause much pain to make the tree feel much pain, again, what will happen that it will not cause any death of the tree. The bleeding bark, see, there is repetition of sound B, which is consonant. Okay, this is an example of alliteration. Moreover, bleeding bark will heal. Bleeding bark is compared to that of the bleeding human being. When cut is made, blood oozes out. Okay, and ultimately what will happen? It will be healed after some time. How the wound is healed? Because you know, in human beings, there is a clotting process. Okay, there is clot of blood, or you can say clotting of blood takes place. Okay, and ultimately what happened after some time? Yes, skin heals, because the damaged tissues, they are replaced by the worn out ones, they are replaced by the newer ones, and ultimately that wound is healed. Similarly, so bleeding bark, here it is also an example of metaphor. Okay, to what it is compared to? It is compared to that of the bleeding, wound of a human being, out of which what comes out, you can say blood oozes out. The bleeding bark will heal, and from close to the ground will rise curled green twigs. And from close to the ground, from where it is cut, from where the cut is made, from that very ground, new leaves, they will sprout out. New twigs, they will come out, giving a new life to the tree. Okay, green twigs. Miniature boughs. Miniature means very small. Boughs means cluster of leaves that will form small canopies like that. Okay. And ultimately what will happen? Miniature boughs. Very small, you can say, cluster of leaves, branches, they will formulate. Okay. Shady areas. And which if unchecked will expand again to former size. Unchecked means if we will not keep a check to it, again what will happen? It will again regrow into its former size, to its earlier size. So here this is also again an example of enjambment, that is miniature boughs, which if unchecked will expand again to its former size. Okay, right? So which one? Miniature boughs, which if unchecked will expand again, means if you will not keep a check on the growth of the tree. Means once you have made the cut, and again what will happen after some time, what will happen? It will regrow again. Okay, so that will also not bring the end to the life of a tree. This means that this will not kill a tree alone. Okay, so what you need is, you have to keep a check in order to stop growing. Okay, it means that tree will consume air and sunlight. It will take natural resources, okay, it will take air, water, okay, and sunlight, and it will again grow. It means that it is not killed in that manner. Okay, so right, so this is all that we have to do for this poem till today. Tomorrow we will continue it further.